After a mid-season break, Extra Time is back here on Palace Player in the Selhurst Sun ahead of a massive trip to Blackburn on Saturday. And what better way to start this show than from the spot where Glenn Murray did this against Rovers back in November. Over the past month or so, the games are becoming thick and fast for the development side, so let's have a look at the last five matches with all the goals, including some absolute crackers. Having drawn two and lost two of their opening four games in the restructured development league, Palace travelled to Manchester City last month looking to record their first victory, but fell behind after 30 minutes when John Guidetti saw a shot deflect past David Gregory. That maiden win looked doubtful when Daedric Boyata bundled the ball in 8 minutes later, but Palace dragged themselves back into the game with a quick-fire double. Some great control and delivery from Kwesi Appiah put Ibra Sikaja in on goal, and the striker's effort had just enough power to creep into the net. Minutes later and he was celebrating again when a fine pass by Cadel Daniel landed perfectly for Sikaja, who sent an arrowed strike into the bottom corner to level things up. However, Attilio Lombardo's men still managed to head into the interval in the lead when Siko Fofana tucked the ball past Gregory in first half stoppage time. After the break though, Gary Issett's side once again grabbed an equaliser. Daniel picked the ball up on the right and headed towards a City goal before unleashing a powerful shot past the helpless Ian Lawler. And if you thought that was good, then 3 minutes later the Eagles notched an even better strike to claim the points. A long ball over the top found Appiah, who blasted the ball over Lawler and into the net to secure a fantastic victory for his side. Only 5 days later, the sides met again for the reverse fixture, with City including Mika Richards and Maicon in their ranks, but this time it was Palace who took the lead through Darcy Blake's header on 17 minutes. There was to be drama at the end of the first half yet again, as City equalised when Albert Rusmak's low centre went in past Lewis Price off Connor Diamond, but the Eagles went on to claim another well-deserved point. That game had been played at Tooting & Mitcham FC, and 5 days later Stoke City travelled to the Imperial Fields as the fixtures came thick and fast for the Eagles. The trend of early goals continued here again, as Adam Thomas had the simple task of tapping home after 3 minutes to give the Potters the advantage. 8 minutes later and it was 2-0 when Jordan Richardson got his head onto a corner kick to put his side in the driving seat, but Palace pulled a goal back to give themselves a chance. Aruna Dindan was making his first appearance in the red and blue stripes and celebrated the occasion with a goal as he continues to gain fitness. Sikaja's pass found the Ivorian, who finished in style to reduce the deficit, but his side couldn't quite find another leveller in the second half as Stoke held on. Last week saw Reading travel to Beckenham to take on Issett's side, and only 3 minutes had elapsed when Appiah was in the perfect position to convert Alex Nimley's corner from close range. The win was sealed after 20 minutes when the Eagles hitman scored his second of the game and his ninth in 11 appearances at this level, as he got a touch onto Ryan Innes's towering header to register another win. 4 days later, when Palace made the long trip north to Newcastle to play in the vast surroundings of St James's Park, but they encountered a strong Magpies side who took a quick lead through Gabriel Lobotan. Having scored when the sides drew 2-2 at Selhurst earlier in the year, Jamaican teenager Rolando Ahrens netted against Palace again with a sumptuous strike to make it 2-0 at half-time. It was game over minutes into the second half when Obertan latched onto another through ball and his shot had too much power for David Gregory. The French winger completed his hat-trick as he used his pace to once again escape from the Eagles' defence, although it took him two attempts to collect the match ball after being thwarted by Gregory. Next up for Palace is a reunion with former Eagles development boss Jamie Fullerton, who brings his Bolton side to Tooting & Mitcham on Monday night. There were some special guests on the training ground this week, as players and staff met up with youngsters from a local children's home invited down by the CP Frist Children's Charity, so we popped down to Beckenham to see how they got along.
Paul, we're down at the Beckenham training ground. Obviously got some visitors here this morning, some of the youngsters that have come down, not only to see the team train, but actually to meet the players.
Which they've done, and they've thoroughly enjoyed it. Christine's done a wonderful job organising it all. We've got some lunch for the children later on. The players have been fantastic. They've been signing autographs and talking to the kids, so it's been wonderful. Absolutely fantastic. I mean, these children, as you know, are disabled children. They come to games using one of the executive boxes where they can watch football in comfort and safety. And they're actually all becoming Palace fans, which is wonderful. And of course, we have the Christmas party, which the club hosts at in Speroni's. And that's usually the first Monday in December. And that's when we normally have around about 130 children there, plus their carers. And we get Pete and Alice, the mascots there. The Crystals have been there the last couple of years. And often the players are there as well to serve the kids with tea. So it brings a great way of the children, you know, getting in contact with the club, not just the players, but the Crystals and the mascots as well. So it's fantastic.
After scoring a beauty against Leicester on Saturday, we caught up with Stephen Dobby to get his answers to six of the best.
There's been quite a number of when I was coming through the ranks at Rangers. There was the boys coming back from injury, like Van Bronckhorst and De Boer and Avaladze. So I'd say for that, to when I was a young boy playing with the best players at that time. I'd probably go for Frank De Boer when I played for Hibernian against Rangers. Just to play against someone like that was, to be on the same pitch, was fantastic, and luckily I managed to score that goal in that game as well. I think it's got to be a cup final goal for Swansea against Reading.
Kaya, Kazanishvili, a rare chance, it's three, it's Dobby, and it might be all over before half time. Stephen Dobby for Swansea, who lead by 3-0 with not even 40 minutes played.
Yeah, I think that as well. I think just the 90,000 and what it meant to the fans and what it meant to the players to get to the Premiership. Keeps coming back to the same, but I think over the twice I've managed to winning the playoff finals, so I think I would say the playoff finals. I'd like to get back to the Premier League. I think I've played maybe 10, 11 games and maybe didn't get as many games as I would have liked, but I'd like to do it with the gaffer here, and I think that's, I think the Scotland thing as well would be great, but it's all about getting Palace to the Premiership.
Joel Ward was fantastic. He's been out for such a long time. He got a bit tired toward the end. I enjoyed Maurice's performance as well at times.
Could Dr. Jasper contact the control room immediately, please? Could either Dr. Jasper or Dr. Hamill contact the control room immediately, please, over?
Good God. Is that not the worst place for that thing? Ever? Eh? Don't let that bloke get hold of that mic, otherwise I'll never sleep. You know, because there's a bit of disappointment growing because of the expectation. That's ridiculous.
Could Dr. Jasper or Dr. Hamill, Dr. Jasper, please contact the control room immediately. Thank you.
Dr. Jasper, if you're watching this, please hurry up. You're needed. Yes, hang on, he's got a question.
I was just wondering, what with the...
Oh, go out of it.
Yeah, cancelled, Dr. Jasper, thank you. Dr. Hamill has attended, thank you.
Saturday sees Palace travel to Ewood Park to take on Blackburn Rovers, so here's all the team news ahead of a big clash at both ends of the Championship table. Jonathan Parr will miss the rest of the season after sustaining ankle ligament damage against Ipswich last week, but skipper Mile Jedinak is back after serving a two-match ban for his 10 yellow cards this season. Owen Garvin could be in contention again after recovering from a knee injury, and Johnny Williams should be fit again after missing the Leicester game with a knee knock. With the Eagles in touching distance of a top six place, what better way to end this show than to take a look back at Palace's first taste of playoff glory back in 1989 when they beat Rovers 4-3 in a thrilling encounter at Selhurst.
Like the legend of the Phoenix, all ends with beginnings. What keeps the planet spinning? The force from the beginning.